So I get a lot of questions about time crawl training, VO2 max training, but I'll tell you how to properly do a recovery ride, easy ride, scream down the legs. So when you're doing a recovery ride, just spin your legs indoors on the rollers, nice and high cadence, super low watts, and ride till the first drop of sweat drops down on your handlebar. It's about 20 minutes of riding normally. And that's a real good recovery. I don't think without having a nice coffee ride, there's an advantage of going out and doing 2 hours. So I've done a short spin. I also think it's very useful to increase your, like not increase, to have better dead spot performances. So lower your dead spots. And as many of you see, professional riders are able to ride at a high cadence, at high power output. It helps a lot when you do super high cadence for some time, like easy power, super high cadence, 20 minutes, like I did now. Really improves your neurosurgery, like the how your brains tell your muscles to do what they have to do. It might feel super hard to do 120 cadence for over 1 minute if you're not used to it, but when you do it more often, it will feel more easy, and it will also feel more easy to do high powers at 100 watts. It will not be a problem at all anymore. That's why I think it's useful to do recovery sessions on the free rollers, Tax Galaxia, I use for this. I just get like 10 bars in my tire, so I have almost no resistance. I get a super high cadence. I just focus on smooth, long, smooth, round pedal strokes. As you can see, you don't want like this pushing pa 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 pa, that you lose the tension on your chain. You want, of course, a constant tension on your chain, and you want to be more or less steady in the saddle. If you feel like you're rocking all the way, there is no tension on your chain, then you are overreaching. That's not where you want to be. Might be useful to do like some kind of intervals, do like 1 minute, 110, if you feel comfortable at 110, and try to do 1 minute plus 10 RPM just to get out of this comfort zone, go back to 110 plus 10 RPM. Like this, you can increase your comfort zone concerning pedal frequency. Pedal frequencies, I don't say this is the key to become a good rider, but it really helps when you do some trainings on pedal efficiency, pedal frequency. You will have a more easy time when you go out on the road to spin the legs. Also, there is some research on the higher your maximum frequency is. So in a sprint without resistance, it should be close to 200. It's not easy, but it should be close to 200. The higher it is, the more efficient your pedal stroke is. So the more pedal efficiency you have. So it's closely related, which makes sense, because when you don't have any control of the pedals, it's almost not possible to sprint without resistance, because you're not able to pedal around anymore. Okay, I hope you liked these tips, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel.